Hey, and welcome to 60 Seconds Re-atomized. I've never played this game, so it should be interesting. I've seen someone play the sequel, and I had this in my Steam library, so I was like, seems like a fun time. Might as well try the first one. Let's see, Atomic Drill. Probably should do the tutorial first. Learn all about how to scavenge and survive the event of a nuclear apocalypse. This tutorial was 100% approved by the establishment. Also, the music doesn't loop in the main menu. So it's eerily quiet right now. Soup. Beautiful tomato soup. Looks a bit mushy. Welcome to your atomic scavenge drill. He's saying things fast, I can read them. Hold the grab control to skip my words, but every time you do, the rest will drop an extra nuke. No time waste, get moving and head to the marked point in front of you. Move it. Oh, okay. This is some odd controls. Mouse turns you and then you have like... I don't know. It's weird. Move to the marker in the living room. Okay. Can do. Not bad, but you better be in good shape. There's more where that came from. Thank you. Sure. Find Timmy. But time's over. It's a matter of life or death. Find your son Timmy now. Is this all the music we're gonna get? Is just this lady trying and failing at playing? Tuba. Got a laundry basket? What is that? Oh, well, it's gone now. Oh, there's Timmy. I do not know the layout of this house. I'm sorry to inform you. Grab Timmy. I have grabbed Timmy. Do I put Timmy in here? I cannot grab her. Can I grab a lady over here? Nope. Find the highlighted soup can and grab it. And there's soup over there. Is it kitchen soup? It's kitchen soup. There we go. Soup, an excellent choice. I think it's to sustain a family of four for a day. Find the highlighted water bottle and grab it. Every American atomic shelter also needs a supply of water. Something, something, something. Kinda wish it wasn't this weird top-down view. Can't see off into the distance. This tuba is going to drive me insane. Where's the water? It's gotta be the bathroom. There we go. Another laundry basket. You got yourself a problem, Buster. Oh no. My hands are full? Yep. You can only carry so much. And every item weighs at least one slot. You need to drop whatever you're carrying at the hatch before you can pick up more. This is a cursed tuba. Please stop. There we go. Timmy, get in the hole. Nice barbecue in there. Got food, water, and even little Timmy. I need a radio. If I was a radio, I would probably be in the living room to listen to, right? Yeah, there we go. Put that radio in there. You just got a picture of like a nuclear symbol on your wall? Sometimes you get a few extra seconds before the siren sounds to scout your surroundings, but after it goes off, you need to start packing. Collect 5 items and drop them off in the shelter in time. Fairly advanced warning system gives you 60 seconds. Scavenge what you need and get yourself to safety. I'm just gonna take all this soup. at least 5 more items and family members in the next 60 seconds to make sure you find yourself close to the shelter when time is up. I'm just gonna load up on soup. Grab that soup. He's very slow in grabbing the soup. Let's see, gotta get soup. Get the Tuba Lord. Drop her off. Probably a gun seems like a good idea. Yeah, sure. Checkers and some water. Another soda. Not a soda, but a soup. Drop soup. Suitcase. Map. Oh, I cannot. The suitcase is too big. Okay, and I didn't want to grab lady here. Lady. Water, I guess. I think flashlight is one. Flashlight's one. It is one. Good. 15 seconds. That means I can just load up on this soup. Grab the stuff. And look, please. Yes, look. Excellent. That's probably good, right? I have no idea how much stuff in total I grabbed. Granted, it's just a drill, so it doesn't really matter, I guess. Now you know how to get what you need to survive, but your training is far from over. See you downstairs for survival training. Okay. I don't know if I would jump in. Seems a bit dangerous. You're gonna break a leg. And I suppose you'll have nothing but time to heal down there. Water. Day one. Well, they sure do have a lot of stuff. Day one. You made it to the shelter. Congratulations, but the drill's not over yet. You'll end up here with whatever and whoever you brought with you. Nothing else. You'll need to make the most of it. Oh, that's good. The next few days will teach you how to survive down here while the world outside burns. Explore and interact with your surroundings. You can always find out useful things about your shelter and its inhabitants when your survival journal is not opened yet or hidden. First things first, you must ration food and water. If you don't wine and dine yourself and the folks you brought with you, you can bet your bottom dollar none of you will ever see the light of day. Again. Okay, it just keeps going, doesn't it? As long as you have food and water available, ration it out to a given person by selecting the picture of a can or bottle under their portrait. Or instantly rationing out both by clicking on the character's image. Of course, you might save your supplies for later, but a normal person can only survive 4 days without water. As to food, the longer you deny your people's rations, the weaker they will get and might eventually get sick. Even if you manage to cure them, it'll take quite a few cans and a lot of time to replenish their strength. And ration supplies. So, from sounds of it, I have 4 bottles of water. I should wait until day 3 before giving them water, but food every day. So I'll give, food, but no water. The one thing they need water, it's soup. That's got some liquids in it. It's close enough. Since this is your first day down here, you'll need to get used to your surroundings. Believe me, ventilation hung can drive anyone nuts if you don't occupy yourself with something to do. Get some decent rest and we'll carry on to tomorrow, nighty-night. Oh, okay. Should have brought a razor. Good morning, survivalist. Day 2. Hope you slept well. Bed's comfy enough? No? Well, better get used to it since you'll be staying here for a while. We'll start today's activities with rationing since you need to do it every day. But after that, we'll move on to something else. Got your attention? Good. Now listen, there is a risk you will run out of supplies eventually. Everything can be useful, but food and water are critical to your survival. If they're gone, you'll be gone sooner than you can say corn dog. So sometimes you'll need to send people to the surface to bring more supplies. And this book is looking rough. You'll do this by preparing an expedition a day before it actually departs. Be careful though, tired survivors can never be part of an expedition. Today we will skip preparations and jump directly into sending someone brave outside. There isn't much going on with Ted. No trouble, nothing new. It's always better when things are calm. Luckily nothing new having to marry Jane today, so I think this probably pops up every day. So nothing new, seemingly. Time to ration supplies. I guess everyone gets some soup. So, is this... Is one can feed four people? I guess one can feeds four people. It did say one can feeds four people, but I wasn't sure if that was just flavor text or not. But I guess one can feeds four people. Okay. Sending people out to the wasteland is no walk in the park. Do it too early or without a gas mask, and you can bet it's a suicide mission for them. Send healthy and well-fed people. Sick, hurt, or crazed people are more likely to perish. And send one person at a time. Let's give it a try. This time, you will need to send someone out. But if you ever want to skip a trip to the surface, don't select anyone. We'll send old dad out here. He's gonna take the gun with him? He should take the gun. He did not take the gun. Could have at least taken like the flashlight or something. Okay. Day 3. This is a drill, so your explorer will come back after a little while. But in an event of a real apocalypse, they might be gone for a couple of days. In the meantime, you'll be faced with other problems that'll test you to the limits. I'm talking about making decisions that can break even the best of men's moral spine. We'll see what clay you're made of, but first, ration your food and water. We don't want anyone starving now, do we? And Ted left. Everyone needs water. Yep, it's day 3. Everyone needs water. Yep. Okay. So everyone gets soup and water today. Oh, yep. Give Timmy his water. Oh, every water is also 4 people worth. Day 3. I'm an army man, but I don't know a second about imagination, but you could probably use yours now. Picture this scenario. You come across your kid's hamster, who in some bizarre way found its way to the shelter. The kids are obviously going to love it, and so will you. There's nothing better than food that comes to you on its own. So do you. Do you cook him? No, don't cook the hamster. Why would you cook the hamster? We got like 18 cans of soup. Oh man, it never ends. Day 4, good choice. A little furry guy can stay and fatten up. He'll make a bigger meal in a few days. It may be your only source of food if you run out of cans. And everyone is doing good. Well, everyone gets some soup today. No water. Day 4, you might be faced with decisions that require you to use your equipment. However, sometimes you might find you don't have that one item that was supposed to save the day. So make sure you scavenge the right supplies before the blast. Keep in mind, every item can be used for something. What do you want to do today? Clean a rifle, listen to the radio, or maybe play some Shadow Bunnies with a flashlight? I'll listen to the radio. How dirty could that rifle be? It's been sitting around. Like, I guess there could be dust and stuff. Oh no. Is he wearing... What is he wearing? A cup on his leg? Is that supposed to be a cast? The radio is critical to establishing communications for the U.S. Army. Burger. It's just a burger over here. As well as listening out for any trouble that might be headed your way. If you get lucky, maybe you'll catch some music, too. Good news, everyone. The expedition is back. Sometimes they'll return with extra supplies. Sometimes they won't. Other times, they'll come back with nasty injuries or even radiation sickness. Believe me... You don't want to get those. I hear something in the dark isn't, or I hear glowing in the dark isn't as fun as it sounds. This time, your explorer was hurt, but they will recover after proper use of a first aid kit. You can use one during rationing. Ted was hurt. Stomach, he's hungry. She's feeling safe? Okay. Feeling fine. Timmy's feeling fine. So you need a med kit and soup. Do you need water? No. Everyone else needs soup. I guess they'll need water tomorrow. I guess maybe their thirst doesn't go down, or maybe he drank something outside. I don't know. Granted, realistically, he just went back up to the house because this is still the drill. So he ran up there and fell down a flight of stairs? Well, I don't understand how he got hurt if there's no nukes yet. You need at least one alive adult to keep going. If you send your only survivor to the surface, you won't know what's happening in your bunker until they come back. And when they do, your shelter might already belong to someone else. A decent padlock may protect it, but not for long. This was a busy day. Take your time and get some sleep. If you make it this far, or if you made it this far, you're doing great and have a chance of getting out of this foxhole. Hopefully soon, but don't quote me on that. Can't really quote him if we don't know his name yet. We have Ted and Timmy. Oh, I guess, like, Dolores and Megan, maybe? I don't remember the other guys' names. Day 6. We only just sent someone outside, but let's give another go today, shall we? First time you were only asked to pick one lucky... Fa? I don't know what that was supposed to be. Okay. One brave volunteer to save the day. This time, you'll also get a chance to equip your explorer with some useful gear. Feed your troops, and I'll see you at the shelter entrance. See? Yeah. Oh, Mary Jane is her name. Okay. So, everyone needs water, and Ted is hungry. Okay, then someone wants to kill themselves. Great. So everyone gets water and soup today. I got all the rations. Most of them, at least. Let's see. Well, he's healed up. I'm gonna give him the suitcase. I cycle through things. Give him the suitcase and give him a gun and a map. That seems like that's what you want, right? Being able to carry stuff, being able to shoot stuff, and be able to find out where you're going. Can I send more than... I only send one person out. I'll just send Ted out. Don't die, Ted. And he really likes that Boy Scout book, huh? Empty first aid kit. Okay. Day 7. Morning, people. You've probably asking yourself one simple question. What's the point of staying in this atomic shelter? Why don't I just leave? Well, leaving is a death sentence. If the radioactive sickness doesn't kill you, then the giant scorpions will. You can trust me on that. Your one chance is our boys arriving to rescue you. So every good citizen needs to do one thing. Seek contact with the U.S. military and await rescue. Ted left for the surface, and everyone else is doing good. So, soup. Still day 7. No. The rescue ain't coming today, but we'll come get you eventually. You'll need to keep your radio operational and be ready to venture into the wastes. However, you also need to be careful. It might not be our soldiers out there. There could be bandits or worse, commies. Just imagine what will happen if rats discover you. So let's agree to the rules for this drill. You only open this door if someone knocks 2 times. Sure. Just wait until someone knocks 2 times. Except Ted. Did Ted knock 2 times? We let him back in here. He didn't bring the suitcase back. He brought the map and the gun, but not the suitcase. How did you do that? Day 8. You'll need to remember that some days will be very tense. A lot of things will happen that you need to be prepared for. That's why any day that gives you a break is a blessing, and you'll need to make sure you make the most of it. Eat, drink, and relax while thinking about all those commies who don't have comfortable bunkers like you. That thought always gets me through the day. Ted has safely returned from his voyage to the surface. A proud Ellison hotel was completely destroyed. Piles and piles of luggage were lying between heaps of rubble. Only a few rooms on lower levels partially survived. Now we know the secret of the restaurant chef. It's tomato soup. No wonder they were a 5-star hotel. Every room was stocked with water bottles for guests. A few of them remained relatively untouched. Lobby was mostly destroyed and barely anything could be found on the floor except for one very hairy and very dead lumberjack. He had an axe in his hand. And the suitcase is gone. For some reason. Goodbye, suitcase. Ted is somehow still hungry. I keep giving him food. Jane's safe. Glory's fine. Timmy's fine. Give everyone their daily soup. As long as you keep your shelter stocked and remain cautious, you should be okay. However, every choice you make may come back to bite you. Even after a few days or weeks, consider your options carefully. This is a drill, but if the nukes start dropping, it'll be a totally different story. This is a very long tutorial. Day 9. If I were you, I'd check the door. Our extraction team might be coming for you any day now. But be careful, this is a post-apocalyptic scenario, and you never know what's coming. See, everyone's hungry, or I guess Ted is hungry, but everyone else is hungry and thirsty. I don't understand why Ted is so hungry all the time. So inside the door, you hear several knocks. If you listen closely, you can make out a sequence of 3 knocks. That's the wrong knocks. Day 10. Good call, that wasn't the knock you were waiting for. Caution at all times, remember. Be cautious, apply yourself, and maybe you and your family will be just fine. Ted's hungry and he's thirsty, and then everyone else is the same. Give everybody some water. No one needs water except for Ted. Ted needs water, they only need soup. As you were counting imaginary sheep in your head, another series of knocks broke your concentration. Someone is really hammering on your door and probably not taking no for an answer. 2 knocks. Well, 2 knocks, I believe, is the correct amount of knocks. Hey, the end. Atomic drill. That's an achievement. You can't see it down here, but it popped up. The end. Good job. You're safe and sound with our brave soldiers. Now you can all have some apple pie. You deserve it. We spent 11 days in shelter. Atomic drill begins, hotel raiders, and successfully pass the drill. We have survived. We didn't really do much, but we survived the tutorial. Hooray, I don't need to... Who would I share my adventure with? Besides the obvious. Medkit. Ranging from paper cuts to decapitations. Hey, the menu finally has music again. That's nice. Also, you can click on